Hello, I'm Michael Cusumano, a professor and currently deputy dean for faculty at the MIT Sloan School of Management. In this video, which is based on a column I wrote for Communications of the ACM in October 2023, we'll explore a potential game changer in the digital world, the emergence of generative AI as a new innovation platform. Now, what's an innovation platform? It's a foundational technology with products and services built on top of it. Examples include operating systems like Microsoft Windows, Apple iOS, and Google Android, as well as broader system platforms like personal computers and smartphones. With innovation platforms, you'll often see network effects. To start, third parties create their own products and services accessed through the platform. More applications attract more users, which leads to more applications and even more users. The platform becomes increasingly valuable with these networks of users and applications. Growth in usage then enables continual improvements in the foundational technology. Now, generative AI shows signs of becoming a powerful enabling technology and innovation platform, but it isn't fully there yet. The foundation models are rapidly evolving, but there is still no one dominant player. However, the technology has advanced enough to support a growing ecosystem of applications, infrastructure providers, and specialized use cases. Let's look at how generative AI emerged as a new platform technology. Artificial intelligence and machine learning has taken decades to develop, but some recent events have been especially important. In 2017, researchers at Google published a key paper showing how neural networks could analyze and then predict language patterns rather than just individual words. Those researchers went on to firms like OpenAI. Then OpenAI introduced GPT-3 in 2020 and ChatGPT in 2022. These new tools brought generative AI into the mainstream. This whole class of systems can generate text, graphics, audio, and video using learning algorithms based on large language models, or LLMs, that train on huge data sets, almost whole languages. The potential applications are vast. Now, a huge class of generative AI systems has emerged. Several hundred startups already target this space. Generative AI hardware and software currently comprise a $40 billion market, and Bloomberg projects that it could grow to over $1 trillion over the next decade. Now, the generative AI ecosystem has three main layers. First, the foundational models and related development or programming tools. Users can access generative AI chatbots through internet browsers, but the underlying computing environment is the LLM software. The major players in this space include OpenAI and Microsoft with ChatGPT and Bing, Google with DeepMind, Bard, and AlphaFold, and Meta with Llama 2. Second, there's the specialized infrastructure needed to run generative AI systems. These models require GPU chips optimized for parallel processing. NVIDIA leads in the GPU space, while cloud giants like AWS, Microsoft Azure, and Google provide the data center infrastructure. Third, we have applications for users and developers. For example, Microsoft and Google added LLMs to their search engines, providing easy access to this technology for billions of people. You'll also find vertical startups targeting use cases across products and services for manufacturing, healthcare, finance, media, construction, agriculture, and more. In summary, foundational models and development tools set the stage, infrastructure powers them, and applications realize their potential. However, this brings us to our next question. What are the risks posed by widespread deployment of generative AI? For one, concentration of market power is almost inevitable, given platform dynamics with network effects and the enormous financial resources required to develop and run these systems, we're likely to see consolidation down to just the biggest tech giants. Second is content ownership and privacy. Generative AI models train on data scraped from the public web. Some scraping has been allowed for search engines, but courts and legislators will have to answer the new trillion-dollar question. What is fair use of training data for generative AI systems? Then there are rising concerns over information accuracy and authenticity. We know there is a lot of bias built into AI algorithms based on the data they train on and the people who built them. Also, when LLMs cannot find an answer to a query, they use predictive analytics to make up reasonable responses, but sometimes they are incorrect. These hallucinations currently limit potential applications. There are questions around self-regulation versus government oversight as well. A collaborative approach between industry leaders, policymakers, and experts to establish ethical norms is essential to help guide responsible development. The environmental impact of these technologies is rising fast. By some estimates, generative AI's use of computing resources has been increasing exponentially for years and already has become an enormous use of energy in data centers. Then there are unintended consequences. For example, these technologies could replace, enhance, or greatly alter many human jobs and occupations, for better or for worse. In closing, generative AI should bring many positives, but we have to manage this increasingly powerful technology very carefully. With models advancing so rapidly, this new platform can potentially transform everything from scientific discovery to education and business. Industry, government, and company leaders will need to collaborate closely to establish guardrails for responsible innovation. The future of this technology is just emerging, and so this is the moment to shape what comes next.